What's up, guys? It's Chase from Chase's Workshop, and in this video, we're going to set up our Arduino Nano board to run our Gauss meter. And basically, if you haven't done any Arduino stuff ever, you should be able to watch this and be able to get this thing uploaded. Now, I had a few issues with my website trying to get the code to download, so I fixed that, and that's actually on there now where you can go and check it out, and I'll go into that in more depth here in just a minute. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open up this Nano board, and there's one piece of information we need to get off of this board before we do anything else, and I'm gonna open this up and then show you what I'm talking about. Okay, so here's the board after I've taken it out of the box. Now, if you look right here on this chipset right here, you'll see some information on it. One of the things you will see is a like mine says Mega 328P on it, is what it says on here. So I know that's what type chip is in this thing. Now, when you bought your Arduino board, it might have said it when you, like, if you got it from Amazon or somewhere like that, it might have said what type chipset it's got in it and everything else. But if not, just look on there and you can see it. It's really hard to see. You kind of got to get it and let it hit the light just right to see it. But anyways, write that information down and just hold on to it for right now. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this thing, I'm going to wire it up into a breadboard, just like it's going into the Gauss meter. It's going to have everything done to it, except it's not going to have the code on it, and I don't have another Hall effect sensor to put on there, so I can't put that on it. But that's where we're going to be on that, so stand by. Well, all right, guys, so we've got everything hooked up, as you can see over on the breadboard, just like we did in the video, but we don't have any code on the Arduino or anything. Now, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go into just a blank sketch here, and we're going to set it up for our, well, before we do that, actually, we can go and get the code and stuff like that and download the library. So let's do that first. We're going to click here. I'm going to go to my website here. And if you come down here to the bottom, there's Liquid Crystal LCD I2C Library Download Link. If you click on that, it's going to take you to this page here. Just click it. Once you click it, it's going to download it down here. And you're going to see it right here. You can show it in your folder. Right-click on it, extract all, and then browse to your Arduino IDE library, which is going to be in computers, local disk C, come down to program files by 86 here, and then go to Arduino, and then to your libraries, and click OK, and it's going to extract those libraries into that folder where it'll be in your sketches when you upload them. All right, so that's all there is to that, and it's pretty simple to do that. The next thing you want to do is we can check for our I2C scanner link. Now, this is only going to be if you're having issues with I2C not working. And all you have to do for this guy is right-click on it or click on it. When it comes up, it's going to bring you to this page here. Come down here to the bottom, click Get Code, and then we're going to insert it into a blank file here. So there's our I2C scanner code. Now, I'm going to check this right quick too, and once you change this, you'll be good for the next part of it if you didn't even do this part. But you want to compare your tools, and if you remember, we got the processor, what type processor we're using, what type board we're using, all that from our Arduino board. And what you need to do is you need to come to Tools right here, go to Board, we're using Arduino Nano, put in here whatever you're using, click on it, come back to Tools, go to your processor, and if you remember, we were using the AT Mega 328P processor. So whatever yours is, make sure you click on that. And then the other thing is, I'm gonna set this as COM3 just for now, so I'm going to show you what I'm talking about here in just a minute. Now, I've got this file that we just downloaded for the I2C scanner, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to upload it to my Arduino board. So I'm going to click Upload right here. This little button right here. Okay, as you can see here, it says an error has occurred. So what it is, more than likely, anything is that we've got the wrong COM port. And basically what this is it's your USB port. And this thing can change too. So if you cut your computer off, cut it back on, they might change. I need to use COM5 now. The next time I plug up, I might need to use COM3. It just depends. So if you get an error like this, this is probably what it is. So click COM5 and click Upload again and see if that works. As you can tell, everything's good. It says done uploading. So now, the way we check for our I2C, what our path is we come back to Tools up here and go to our serial monitor. And it's going to spit out a number here. It says scanning I2C device found at address 0x27. So that's, we need to remember this part right here. So remember 0x27, write it down, whatever you have to do just to remember it. And then we can exit out of this code here. Now, the next part you need to do is just go back to my website here and go down here to this click for the download sketch. Now, I had it on here to where it was basically just code. You just highlighted it and copied it and pasted it just like we did with the I2C scanner. But I was having an error with that. For some reason, my website was using a different quote than the IDE software used. So when I'd upload it, it would throw a bunch of errors. So I changed that to where you can click on this now and download it. So if you just click on this, it's going to bring you here. You click download right here, and it's going to put it down here in this file. And if I take this, I'm going to try to open it. I'm having issues opening it because I've got like five of those on here now where I've tested this thing out. So I'm going to try to see if I can get it to work right here. Okay, so it's going to give me, it's going to say I had an error with that and everything, but hopefully it will not. Okay, so I've got the file uploaded, and this is the one I just was having issues because I've got two of those on there already. And I can't find the exact file. So basically what I did was I took the file that I downloaded previously and finally got it to upload on here without. And it was basically just because I had two files named the same thing and everything else. So you shouldn't have any issues with this. But now once this is uploaded, as you can see here, this is the code for it. Now, we just did the I2C scanner. If you look right here on the code, this 0x27, that's our path or address that we found from the I2C scanner. So whatever you're said there, put it in right here. And then that should be good. Everything should be good with that. So we've got everything right and everything set up. Now what we're going to do is we're going to come up here and go to upload. All right, so we're done. And now as you can see on our breadboard, we have our our output on our LCD screen that is just like before. Now I don't have the Hall effect sensor hooked up because I don't have another one, and the one I have is in the Gauss meter now running. So I only bought one of them guys. But anyways, guys, that's really it. I mean, if there's any issues you're having with any of this stuff, just please just send me an email or put a comment on this video or any of the videos. I want to try as much as I can to help you out. I had one of my subscribers, and it's my fault, and I apologize for that because of the code on there where he couldn't get it to upload to his Arduino. And it makes me feel bad, and like I said, I'm sorry for that. I should have done a better job trying to figure all this stuff out. But guys, if you have any questions or comments about any of this stuff, leave them in the below, send me an email, do whatever. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, give me a like. If you like it, please subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys.